Today we will study the mechanism of concentration of the filtrate. In the previous class you have studied physiology of urine formation, and now we will continue this as the mechanism of concentration of the urine or mechanism of concentration of the filtrate. So this we will study with the help of mechanism known as the counter current mechanism. Mammals, they have ability to produce a concentrated urine, and the capability of concentrating the urine is largely related to the length of the loop of Henle, and vasa recta also helps in concentrating the urine. So you can see here that this is the that loop of Henle and this is the vasa recta. Both they help in the concentrating the urine. The flow of filtrate in the two limbs of loop of Henle is in opposite direction. So you'll see here, this is the ascending limb and this one is the descending limb. Means this is the ascending limb and this one is the descending limb of the loop of Henle. So the flow of filtrate in both the limbs is opposite. You can see here the flow of filtrate is downward. Here the flow of filtrate is upward. Okay, so this is in opposite direction and thus forms a counter current. And when we see the flow of blood in the vasa recta too, here also it shows the counter current that of pattern. So the flow of blood flowing the two limbs of the vasa recta, you can see here, this is the one and this is the second limb. In both the limbs you will see that the counter current pattern of the flow, here the blood is flowing upward in the upward direction and here the blood is flowing in the downward direction. So this is named as the counter current mechanism. And the proximity in between the Henle's loop and the vasa recta, as well as this counter current mechanism, help in maintaining an increasing osmolarity towards the inner medullary interstitium from 300 to 1200 in the, means 300 osmolarity it is in the cortex region, to the 1200 osmolarity in the medullary region or in the medulla. And this gradient is mainly caused by the sodium chloride and the urea. So NaCl, it is transported by ascending limb of loop of Henle, which is exchanged with the descending limb of the vasa recta. So it is exchanged with the descending limb of vasa recta, and NaCl is returned to the interstitium by the ascending portion of the vasa recta. So ye NaCl jo hai ye wapas se jo hai return ho jata hai interstitium mein by the ascending limb of vasa recta. So here in the same way, small amount of urea also enters the thin segment of the ascending limb of loop of Henle. Ab yahan par small amount of urea also enter in the ascending limb of loop of Henle, in the thin that portion, which is transported back to the interstitium by the collecting duct. So collecting duct bhi jo hai usko ye transport kar deti hai. I'll show you here. This is the collecting duct. So collecting duct transports the that urea also in the interstitial tissues, medullary interstitium, and the sodium chloride is also transported in the interstitial fluid or medullary interstitium. So in this mechanism, what happens here, this transport of that substance is facilitated by the spatial arrangement of the loop of Henle and the vasa recta. This is called as the counter current mechanism. This mechanism helps to maintain the concentration gradient in the medullary region. So you can see here that this is the outer medulla and this is the inner medulla. So the osmolarity reaches up to 1200 osmolarity in the inner medulla. So This mechanism helps to maintain the concentration gradient in the medullary interstitium, which help in easy passage of water from the collecting tubule. So, यहाँ पर osmolarity जब increase हो जाएगी, then the water from the collecting the tubule here it leaves the filtrate and then enters into the interstitial medullary region. So so it concentrates the filtrate or the urine which is present in the collecting duct. So human kidneys, they can produce urine nearly 4 times concentrated than the initial filtrate formed. So the two osmolites, NaCl and the urea, they maintain the osmolarity gradient in the medullary interstitium. So the water, it comes out means from its region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration, means towards the medullary region, and thus the urine becomes concentrated. Fine. So this is all about the counter current mechanism. Now next we will study that after the concentration of the urine is makes it its way from urinary bladder to the urethra and then outside. So this process of release of urine is called micturition, and the neural mechanism causing it is called the micturition reflex. Now we will study the regulation of the kidney function here, kidney function or the urine formation. Okay, so how the regulation of this urine formation process is taking place. So it is under the control of ADH, it is controlled by JGA, and it is controlled by the atrial natriuretic factor. So one by one we will understand it. The functioning of kidney is efficiently monitored and regulated by a hormonal feedback mechanism involving hypothalamus, JGA up to a certain extent, and the heart also. Osmoreceptors in the body, they are activated by changes in the blood volume, body fluid volume and ionic concentration. An excessive loss of fluid from the body can activate these receptors, which stimulates the hypothalamus to release the antidiuretic hormone or ADH or vasopressin from the neurohypophysis. Now, ADH facilitates water reabsorption from later parts of the tubule, thereby preventing the diuresis. An increase in body fluid volume can switch off the osmoreceptors and suppresses the ADH release to complete the feedback here. So, in this manner, the ADH works on the feedback mechanism. ADH can also affect the kidney function by its constrictory effect on the blood vessels. This causes an increase in the blood pressure. Kyunki constrict kar deta hai blood vessel ko, then it causes the increase in blood pressure. An increase in blood pressure can increase the blood flow in the glomerulus also. That is glomerular blood flow, and increases GFR also, glomerular filtration rate. So in this manner this functioning of the kidney is under the control of ADH. Now we will see here the renin-angiotensin mechanism. Here JGA, juxtaglomerular apparatus. JGA means that I explained you in the previous that class, that juxtaglomerular apparatus. It plays a complex regulatory role. A fall in the glomerular blood flow or blood pressure or GFR activate the JG cells to release the renin. And renin, it converts the angiotensin in the blood to angiotensin 1, further to the angiotensin 2. So, ye angiotensin ka present hota hai? Ye angiotensin present. Angiotensinogen ka present hota hai? This is present in the blood. So, angiotensinogen ko angiotensin 1 or angiotensin 2 mein convert kar deta hai. Angiotensin II, being a powerful vasoconstrictor, increases the glomerular blood pressure and thereby the GFR. Angiotensin II also activates the adrenal cortex to release the aldosterone, and this causes reabsorption of sodium and water from the distal part of the tubule. This also leads to an increase in the blood pressure and the GFR. This complex mechanism is known as the renin-angiotensin mechanism. Now, next we will see ANF. ANF is the atrial natriuretic factor. This opposes the regulation which is done by the renin-angiotensin aldosterone system. Here, an increase in the blood flow of the atria, blood flow to the atria of the heart can cause the release of atrial natriuretic factor. So, atria mein jab blood flow increase hoga, then it releases this ANF. ANF can cause vasodilation, that is dilation of the blood vessels, and thereby it decreases the blood pressure. So, ANF mechanism acts as a check on the renin-angiotensin mechanism. Means this inhibits the absorption of sodium by the collecting duct and reduces release of aldosterone from adrenal gland. It also increases excretion of sodium ion in the urine. So this is ANF or atrial natriuretic factor, which controls the function of kidney. Now we'll come to the renal disorders. So here the renal disorders are there: renal calculi, stone or insoluble mass of crystallized salts formed within the kidney, uremia, accumulation of the nitrogenous toxins, glomerulonephritis, that is inflammation of the glomeruli of the kidney, and acute renal failure, that this is sudden loss of kidney function, may be reversible with the treatment. But chronic renal failure, where kidneys slowly use ability, means slowly lose actually ability to function and not reversible. Cystitis is there. Urinary bladder infection, common in the female. Glomerulonephritis, inflammation of the glomeruli of the kidney, that cause of chronic renal failure. And incontinence is there, that is inability to control the urination. So these are some disorders. Now, malfunctioning of the kidneys can lead to the accumulation of urea in the blood, which is known as the uremia. And this uremia is very harmful and may lead to the kidney failure. And in the chronic, that kidney failure where the kidney does not work, then in such patients, the urea can be removed by the process which is known as the hemodialysis. Here in the hemodialysis, blood is taken out from an artery of a patient. So blood is taken out from artery of a patient and then it is cooled at 0 degree Celsius, and it is mixed with the anticoagulant like heparin, and then it is pumped into the apparatus which is known as the artificial kidney. Ab let me see ki kya structures iske andar present hote hain आर्टिफिशियल किडनी के अंदर. सो हियर वी विल सी दैट आर्टिफिशियल किडनी है. ओके, सो आई शो यू द आर्टिफिशियल किडनी के अंदर जो है क्या होगा. हियर इन आर्टिफिशियल किडनी क्या क्या स्ट्रक्चर्स इसके अंदर प्रेजेंट होते हैं. तो आर्टिफिशियल किडनी के अंदर है एपरेटस के अंदर जो ब्लड है वो फ्लो होता है चैनल्स के थ्रू. ओके सो ब्लड फ्लोज थ्रू चैनल्स और ट्यूब्स बाउंडेड बाय द सेलोफेन मेम्ब्रेन. दिस मेम्ब्रेन इज परमिएबल टू द सोल्यूट्स लाइक यूरिया, यूरिक एसिड, क्रिएटिनिन एंड मिनरल आयंस, बट इम्परमिएबल टू मैक्रो मॉलिक्यूल्स. सो द मेम्ब्रेन सेपरेट्स द ब्लड फ्लोइंग इन साइड द चैनल्स और ट्यूब्स फ्रॉम अ डायलाइजिंग फ्लूइड फ्लोइंग इन हियर आउटसाइड द मेम्ब्रेन. तो मेम्ब्रेन के आउटसाइड जो है वो डायलाइजिंग फ्लूइड है और मेम्ब्रेन के इनसाइड जो है वो ब्लड फ्लो हो रहा है. Now, the dialyzing fluid also contains some small solutes and mineral ions, but does not contain the nitrogenous waste product like urea, uric acid and creatinine. तो क्या होगा, यहाँ पर कंसेंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट सेटअप हो जाएगा. वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स आर मोर इन द ब्लड इन द सेलोफेन ट्यूब्स देन द डायलाइजिंग फ्लूइड हियर. सो दीज वेस्ट डिफ्यूज फ्रॉम ब्लड टू द डायलाइजिंग फ्लूइड अक्रॉस द सेलोफेन मेम्ब्रेन फॉलोइंग द कंसेंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट. दस द ब्लड इज कंसिडरेबली क्लियर from the nitrogenous waste product without losing the plasma protein, and such a process of separating small solutes from macromolecular colloids with the help of selectively permeable membrane, this is known as the dialysis. And the blood combined coming out from the artificial kidney, again it is warmed. Okay, so blood which is coming out from the this dialyzing machine, it is warmed up to the body temperature, mixed with an antiheparin to restore its coagulatory property and return to the vein of the patients. Okay, so it is returned back to the vein through the vein. Hemodialysis saves and prolongs the life of many uremic patients. So in this manner, this artificial kidney works. So students, we have completed the portion, and now you revise it from the book also and ask your doubts.